drink. Four ball. Got a clear shot at the one. Came out nice for the two ball. Now, let's see if that three ball passes by the seven to go in the corner here. That's what he was looking at. As usual, the players will be on a 30-second shot clock. They do get one extension per game, adding an additional 30 seconds to their overall time. Good shot. They keep up nice for the five. Just a stop shot here, I think. See, they have enough angle on the six to get back down for the seven. Well, this game for sure doesn't. Let's see here if he had it. Hey, Anthony's playing well. He's making, staying in line, making the shots, playing smart.
He got in gear at the end of that last match. Mm-hmm.
Okay, this is for game number one. Okay, good shooting there by Anthony. There's a break and run for you. It's a good way to start off the match.
Yes, it is.
Got Carlos Torres as a referee for this one. Chris on the shot clock. Also earlier in the day we had Bob Farrell do a lot of shot clock.
Yes, he did. Wore that boy out.
Uh-huh.
And Glenn McMahon, you know, for reffing.
For reffing.
Charlie Tudor. You know, a lot of good volunteer guys that helped us out.
Yep. Evie and Bobby Lee. Got to give them a big thank you for everything they've done.
Yes. And the players. Showing up and playing.
But most of all, thanks for everybody for tuning in and watching this. That's why we do it. And participation in the chat room. Speaking of which, we have that opened up. If anybody has any comments or questions, type those in there. We'll try to answer them for you. Okay, Anthony breaking game number two. A lot of
that
movement on his breaks there.
Oh boy, I'll tell you, you got a killer break.
Yeah.
Killer break.
This one's set up pretty good too. Layout here. The only, just be careful you don't get behind the eight after making the one.
I know he's smiling a little, so I think he likes it.
Yeah, just be careful. Don't get overconfident here. This one here, I don't know.
He's going to stay on this side of the eight.
Yeah, he wants to draw back a little bit, it looks like.
Yep.
Yeah, punched it out. Good shot there.
Slow down.
That came out really nice. That was good speed control right there. I like that. Because he can draw back and about where the chalk is. Leave an angle though on this five ball.
He did a nice job. It looked like he wanted it to go down further, but I think that's fine.
A little bit on the rail here, but it should be fine here. Bad thing about here, you got to stretch out.
Yeah.
And now he's playing this one left-handed.
It would have been nice if he'd have been over further.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it's a problem at all, though.
Extension.
Well, maybe.
That's for an extension, yeah. I'm going to think about this one for a minute.
I wanted to look at it again.
Yeah, because this is an important shot right here.
Oh, yeah, this is the game.
Kind of set yourself up. Slow down.
Ball sitting there on the stuff yet.
Yeah.
But it left it very makeable. No problem.
No problem?
No.
Okay. Let's rack these up.
Yep. I'm surprised Tony didn't concede this rack. No, you don't ever want to do that.
See what you... that's what you said.
That's why I said he didn't want to concede it, because you never know what's going to happen.
That's right. But you said no problem earlier.
Well, I've watched you shoot those shots so often. Oh, boy. This was a bonus for Tony. I know he was sitting there figuring he wasn't getting a shot.
Mm-hmm. Good shot there.
Yeah. Well, that was a donation. Anthony, he's not happy about that.
All right, now it is 1-1. Got a long way to go.
Oh, yeah, long way to go. But he made the hard shot on the 7, and then... That happens a lot of times, though. You come with the difficult shot, and then you miss the supposed easy shot.
That 8-ball wasn't easy.
No, it wasn't.
Things could go wrong there. He's worried about where the cue ball's going on that shot.
Right.
And ended up undercutting that shot. This is a nice close-up view of Carlos racking the balls there for us. Reflection of the lights in those balls. Won't get that kind of quality in a lot of other streams.
Nope. None that we watch. Try to watch them all.
All right, Tony breaking game number 3.
Yes. Oh, yeah. That worked out all right. The 1-ball was going to knock that in, and Karen blocked that. But anyway, he's still shooting. He can get this 3 in pretty easy. But where does the 1-ball go?
Yeah, I don't know if you want to hit the 3-ball directly. If you didn't go for that, you want to...
You can play the carom on the 6, but this 9-ball sitting up here. He tried to get it.
Yeah, he did.
He tried to get it.
All right, Anthony to the table. Let's see what he does.
Safety.
Can't see the 1-ball, so he's kicking at it from the bottom rail.
You better hope that don't stay over there. Well, you left Tony a good starter here. Ball should go over on Anthony's side.
I don't know if that'll... Oh, yeah. On the opposite side of the 3. Yeah.
Although it looks like he set up to go the other way.
I think it's just going to draw out here.
It's going high.
Wow. He had a different plan.
He must have been trying on hitting them.
Yeah, now he's... in a tough position.
Yeah. Home with 3,000 and the loser goes home with 1,000.
That's a pretty good day.
Yeah, if you win.
The question in the chat room, is that a 10-foot table? Yes, it is. 5x10. It's a 1945 Brunswick Centennial table. It's got 4.5-inch pockets all the way around, covered with 860 Simonis HR series cloth. And the slate on this table is actually is a new piece cut for us about 4 or 5 months ago, I guess. And it's got a deeper shelf on it than a regular.
Just a little bit. A
little bit. And we have another one downstairs, almost identical to this one. Both 1945 Brunswick Centennials, converted snooker tables. They were restored by Mark Gregory of Perfect Pockets of Atlanta, Georgia. You can look him up on the web if you're in the market for any table work to be done. Perfect Pockets with a Z.com. Also, Simonis is one of our sponsors. Give them a plug. Okay, Tony breaking game number 4. Yep, the table plays really good. It's set up nice, it plays fair, it's level, it plays true. We got the environment set up really nice. The air conditioning cools it off, gets the humidity out, and the lighting conditions are really top notch right here. You know, see shadows around the balls and stuff.
Yeah, we get nothing but compliments from the players on the playability. They love to play on them. Matter of fact, Rob Melrose said he never played on a table that rolled so accurate and smooth.
Yeah, it is a pretty table, and it's also pretty to look at. Looking at it on the screen or on the stream, and then in person, it looks even better.
Settled in now, playing serious. Still good.
Okay, this to go to three. Hey, good shooting there by Tony. 3-1 in race to 11. You're watching the Xtreme Pool Challenge. I'm Rick Heffelfinger alongside Gary Patrick. We're streaming live from Cocoa Beach, Florida. This is our final match of the evening.
$3,000 to the winner, $1,000 to the loser. So at least neither one's going home totally empty.
Nope. We've got a little bit more than gas money now.
That's it.
And if you're interested in more information about upcoming events, check out our event calendar on extremepoolchallenge.com and check us out on Facebook.
Like us on Facebook and share us on Facebook.
Mm-hmm. The word of mouth advertisement. And Facebook's a good way to advertise. Also, if you're interested in playing in upcoming events, there's some contact information on the website. Get a hold of Gary. He'll hook you up.
Yeah, and if anyone out there is interested in mobile streaming, we'll travel.
Yeah, we've got a couple things in works right now. Next weekend, be up at Zingali's in Tallahassee, Florida for their tournament on Saturday and Sunday. That'll be a good one. We'll be streaming several tables. And check us out next Saturday and Sunday.
Yeah, it should be some top players. $8,000 in the purse. Look out, nine ball here. Nope. Yeah, $8,000 guaranteed purse. $65 entry only, which is pretty nice.
It is a good deal. I think they got 70-something players signed up for
that. Yeah, I think there were 78 when I talked to Mike the other night. But a lot of people feel it'll go to 100. We'll find out. Got a few of the local guys going up. Anthony Meglino's going, Rob Melrose, Jimmy Sandler, Michelle Monk. And I believe Dan Hines is going also.
Okay, Tony doesn't have a shot here at the twos. Well, maybe he does. He can see part. Good shot.
Oh,
what a bank.
Went for that nine ball, didn't he? Well, I think he just went for that, not really worrying whether he made it. He was trying to get that nine ball. Now he's got to get worried.
Mm-hmm.
He can kick this.
You can kick it one rail, but...
Yeah, just kick it in the corner and then stop it right there.
Yeah, that would be perfect, ideal. Just got to wonder where that three ball is going to end up. That's kind of a tough leave right there.
Not real tough, no. The way Anthony's shooting...
He's making a lot of shots, that's true.
Shots. That seven ball will hinder him a little bit.
Yeah,
he's going to carry him over there.
He's looking at it. He's thinking about it.
I think he's going to do it. I think he's going to go for it. Figure that way he puts the three ball somewhere else, you know. He doesn't have to belt this thing that hard. That's a tough shot to make.
Yeah, it is.
But...
Left it tough for Tony.
He can't get that in the side now. But he can stick them. Let's see what he does.
95.
That was a nice shot. I remember that one.
Mm-hmm.
Just don't use it on me on Wednesday.
I'd mess it up. Jumping over the five here. No, he changed his mind.
Yep.
Kick at it.
And it Anthony's Creek cue maker?
Ted Harris.
Ted Harris.
I can't remember the brake cue maker now. Frank.
He's out of Stewart.
Oh, boy. I'm not sure. I know Ted Harris is his regular playing stick. And Tony's playing with Predator.
Yes.
Anthony's, he plays at a Beyond Billiards in Davie, Florida. And Anthony, he's from Spring Hill. Plays at a.
You mean Tony?
What? Oh, Tony. Well, they're both.
They're both Anthony, but Tony goes by Tony.
Tony Crosby. I'm sorry if I said Anthony. He plays out of Strokers in Spring Hill.
Palm Harbor.
Palm Harbor.
And he also runs the Florida Pool Tour. Safe instead of going for that carom.
Yeah. Those are the things you got to worry about.
Oh, yeah, when you're playing these good players, of course, he knows that. He's a top player. But that cost them a game, that's for sure.
Yeah. Okay, good shooting there by Anthony. Or Tony. God.
4-1. Tony Crosby over Anthony Meglino. This is a race time. So we got a long way to go yet. Anthony's got a lot of time to get back in the hunt. Fussy on the chalk now. I got new chalk in there too if he wants it. Carlos Rodrian. He's a good guy. He helps us out all the time.
Yeah, we couldn't do it without a lot of help.
No. Gotta have all the people that like pool. You're one of the most reliable ones that's showing up all the time.
Trying to do what I can.
Good job. We're just hoping that ESPN doesn't hear you and steal you away.
I don't think you have to worry about that. Another cue ball?
Yeah, right in the thing next to Chris there. I cleaned it ahead of time.
Just in case?
Yeah.
All right, Tony, game number six. Scratch.
Opportunity here for Anthony.
Mm-hmm.
No trouble balls. Ball in hand. Tell him that. Say we got the one in the, I got sitting at the top of that ball cleaner right there.
It looks like he's gonna go around three rails here. For shape.
It's funny, it worked out good for him. I thought he'd come out this way easier. you do it for telescope. You showed us that show.
Yeah, I need to start doing something here. It's just that some of these guys play so fast,
I can't
draw this thing. But we do have a new toy at XPC, and it is really cool. Got this telestrator that you can kind of determine where Anthony's going to go with a cue ball. Maybe. That was pretty close to what he was going to do.
Yeah.
Nice there for the seven ball.
Yes, it did.
Now it's got a little angle on it. Let's see what it does here. Looks like he's setting up for a draw.
Not again, man.
Look outside pocket. Man,
wow,
that's
that hurt. Man.
It is. You get a little adrenaline flowing and you draw that ball back so much. I think that was.
Wow, 4-2 would have been prettier than 5-1.
Yep.
That's just
a mistake there. You can't keep doing those mistakes here, unfortunately. Now with two balls, ball in hand there with Tony Schumann.
Yeah, that's huge for Tony.
Yeah, that was a big game right there.
Oh, yeah.
You had the momentum, you were making the shots, and then just kind of got a little careless on one shot.
He's still all right, but I mean, now
he's
got a lot of work.
Now it's 5-1 here.
Yeah.
Still, that's a big hill to do.
Yeah. 6-10 loss.
Yeah. Anthony needs to get some going. Just can't let Tony creep out so many games.
Nope.
All right, Tony, break in. Game number 7. Made the 1. And this could be a possible 2-9 combo. Tony. Let's see if he had a chance here. He might elect to try to play safe here.
Yep.
That's going to come out for the side pocket and leave Anthony a shot. Well, here's a good chance for Anthony to get something going. Got a good two ball goes in the side. Just needs to get up table on the right side of the floor here. Good shot. Park the cue ball right against the rail, so that's going to create a little problem for him. And he's kind of. Not an easy shot either. And we'll see what he does here with a 5 ball. The side pockets are pretty tough 4.5 inches wide, so making this combo is, looks like that's what he's planning on doing. Shot, overroll with the cue ball. Just a tough little angle on the five. Like he's going to back cut this five ball in the corner. Good shot. Comes around the table. That was fantastic right there. Good shot. And bounces off the rail a little bit. He's got an angle on the six ball to get back up table for the eight. Nicely done. That was a good shot too. Don't get straight in here. Got a little angle to work with. Looks like he's drawing back out two rails. Go down the table.
No.
It's going to work out pretty nice. No, I think it didn't die.
Yeah, just.
I think he's all right.
Yeah, take a little extra time here on this one. You need to pocket the nine ball.
Oh, he has to make this, yeah.
Good shot. Yep. Needed that one.
Oh, yeah.
Close the gap.
Big time.
And now he needs to, one of those three packs he ran earlier today.
Meglino getting ready to break.
He's got a sledgehammer break.
He sure does.
And that time, nothing went into
it. No, and he left Tony a very nice opportunity here. Two balls a little tricky, though. He'll probably, follow this one, you think, Rick, or draw back?
He's got a slight little angle on the one. He can
follow or draw.
Yeah. I don't know what he's going to do here. I can't tell how he's lining up to draw back.
Yeah.
With a little spin. Yeah. It's not bad. That's a good shot.
That was a good shot.
From where he was.
Oh, yeah. It's doable.
I got a comment in the chat room. The audio is lagging behind a little bit. It's lagging behind, or the video is lagging behind? Is the sound coming before the video? And you're picking up the sound of the rack?
Yeah, those Delta racks are noise. As a matter of fact, I've been meaning to buy those little inserts that keep quieter. Because we've got the overhead mic there right over the table, so it picks up that pretty quick.
Sound before the video. So the video's lagging the audio a little bit. See if Kyle can tune that up a little bit for us.
Yeah, sometimes over the course of time it gets out of sync like that.
Oh, oops.
Hoops.
Big opportunity here for Anthony now. Make it 5-3. Of course, there's still a lot of balls on that table. But there, none of them are in trouble.
I think he wanted to bank the four ball cross side. Mm-hmm.
Just but come up a little past the nine.
Yeah. Now he's in an awkward spot here. Let's see what he does.
Extension.
Taking his extension.
Speed on that, got behind the six, that would have been good. Left Tony a long shot on the four.
Didn't cut. Be a good shot if he makes it. It's going to go safe. I don't know. Well, think he'll go for the four or go for the carom? Can't go to carom really because he'll sell out if he misses that thing.
Yeah, I don't like the carom shot. I think he's
go
right
safe
thing to.
Or go.
Well,
for
you
the
can
four.
Play safe. That or would go be for good the four too. Ball. Or go for the four in the corner.
Nice shot. Just like that.
Yep. Good shot.
That was a good shot. Boy, he shoots with the straight. Comes with some big shots.
He likes that sliding over to the side rail, but that one almost didn't come out far enough for him.
No, but he's still okay.
Yeah. Except for the stretching part.
Yeah, that's true.
That
good thing he's tall.
Yeah. But he's still.
Oh, they get a bridge. Or extension. Chris will give him a little pause here on the time we allow him to have a pause to change equipment like that. We don't hold that against him.
That's still, I mean, he's still got, you know,
oh, he's still stretched out
2.5 foot bridge here.
He shoots with a pretty long bridge anyway.
Good shot. Came out really nice for the seven ball on the side.
Yes, it did.
All you gotta do is draw this back a couple inches and play the eight in the corner.
He got up on that shot.
Yes.
You see that?
He's got a little careless on that. He gets to the end and.
Wow.
Unfortunately for him, he just maybe rushes it a little bit or gets distracted just a little bit. Yeah, that's another big game that
he
didn't need to have slip away.
Oh, yeah. Wow, he was there. That would have been 5-3. Now it's going to be 6-2.
Yeah, because he did a lot of work to get there. He made some good shots.
Yeah. Well, he's a great player.
Mm-hmm.
Just I don't know if you'd call that a mental error or just an adrenaline error.
All right.
But
either
it's
way.
6-2.
Yeah, 6-2. Hey, what's the score? That's what matters.
Yeah, that's all that matters. Next week, nobody remembers anything but the score. Like Lombardi always told the guys, no one's ever going to ask you how you played the game.
It's good if you won or lost.
That's all they want to know. because we can all come up with a lot of reasons why we lost, right?
Yeah, there's
an infinite number of
yes.
Does he want that plane?
Yeah, but I get too slippery, it's worse.
Anthony breaking game number 9.
Anthony?
I mean Tony. Golly, I keep doing that.
But, you know, it's he's probably called Anthony, too. No. Everybody knows him as Tony. And Anthony is Anthony. All right. Tony got one on the break there, and he can see and hit the one ball. A 5-9 race. Say 2 games, right?
Yeah, he let a couple games slip away from that last one. Really hurt because
he had a
chance to close the gap there to 2 games. Now it's, you know, you got a 4-game difference right now. That was a big game.
Oh yeah.
Unfortunately for Anthony, that he didn't put that one away.
Safety for Tony or a make. He's up 6-2. You might go for it, but you got to be careful. Good shot. That was a good shot. Now, if he can make the deuce, he's on his way to this rack, then he gets on that 4-ball.
Shot there.
Oh,
ooh, a little wobble there.
Yep. A big break for Anthony.
Yeah, we'll see if he can put this one away. He needs this one desperately.
Oh, yeah. Right now he has to finish this rack.
He just wants to make sure he's got the right angle on the 6-ball to get on the correct side of the 7.
Gotcha.
Because you don't want to play a combination here. You just want to get out. And I think he can draw back just past the side pocket. Should be all right for the 7.
Gonna have
a little too far.
Now he's... Oh, wow, 50-yard line.
Yeah. Still all right here.
Well, just got to make the shot now. Mm-hmm. Take what you get on that 8-ball. He's all right.
Still all right.
Oh,
I mean,
yeah.
He can come around 3 rails here and should be all right. Just
think he'll scratch it there. Or just...
I like three right here. You go one rail or two rails. Yeah, I like that. That's a good speed right there. Well, when I say three rails.
Right, the three rail pattern.
That one just hit two rails. That's what I meant.
I knew what you meant. The groove a little bit there. Tony Crosby missed that shot, which was on the first. Made two great shots ahead of it. They're all tough on this table. I mean, you know, it's not like watching someone play on a 9-foot table.
No, it's totally different. It's much more challenging. Players miss.
Yep.
Plain and simple.
Good players, and you're watching all good players here tonight.
Try to cheat the pocket a little bit here or there, or make something happen with a cue ball and just be off just a little bit. Just because he just misses. All right, Anthony breaking game number 10. Nothing to shoot at here. Made a couple balls on the break, and no shot on the two. I think we'll see a push out here.
Yeah, I think that's the smart thing. I mean, he can hit this, but do you really want to hit it? Oh, maybe. I think I'd push. Yeah, he's pushing. I don't know if he can get between there or not.
I think he can skim the two right there.
If he can, he might take this shot. Yeah, he's giving it back.
Yeah. I don't like this one.
No, not when you have an option. But if he can get right.
If he can skim the two and maybe get behind the nine.
Exactly.
That'll be a good shot here. Or just thin
the nine be a stopper with the six a blocker.
Yeah.
Bad hit. Are we allowed to call bad hits in here?
Oh, we did.
Yeah, we did. Simultaneous. Would look bad if the ref did.
Yeah, well, seen that happen a couple times.
Ball in right. Hand, you hate when you do that to
yeah,
yourself.
Yeah, that's. We've all done that.
Oh, yeah.
That's for sure.
Many times, I couldn't count them all.
It'll happen again, I'm sure.
But giving Anthony hope here.
That's a good shot there, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
I like that one because it came back on the other side of three. A pretty good position here. Easier shot into the corner than the side.
Played it well.
Now this one here,
he didn't get down as far as he did.
Right. Now this one, let's see what he does.
Well, either inside or he's got to spin and come around.
Yeah. Inside here is... hit this one pretty good. I think he's going to go around. Maybe three rails hit the bottom rail.
No.
Hit the nine.
Did he?
Yep. Ran into the nine. He didn't want to hit that one.
No.
Still got a shot here on the five, but
if he makes the five, then the six is not as straight as he shoots.
Yeah, just stay down and make the five ball. hit that one with confidence, too. I like that. That was a good play.
Anthony is a straight shooter.
This one's the bottom round back up.
Characteristic misses.
It's going to turn into a match here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, good shot there by Anthony. Nice out. 6-4 now. Tony Crosby over Anthony Meglino. You're watching Xtreme Pool Challenge. I'm Rick Heffelfinger. Alongside of Gary Patrick, we're hosting Fate of the Eight, number 7 today. We had 8 very good players start off at about 11:30 today. We're down to the last 2 right now. They're playing for $3,000, first place prize money, and second place will get $1,000. Also like to thank our sponsors again, Simona's Cloth, the truest plain cloth out there. They've been in the business since 1680. And both of our tables are covered with Simona's 860 Tournament Blue HR Series cloth. And the tables were restored by Mark Gregory from Perfect Pockets of Atlanta, Georgia. Look him up on the web, perfectpocketswithaz.com. Anybody just tuning in, these are 10-foot tables, 4.5-inch pockets all the way around. And this is the final match of the evening. Got a little break. Anthony stepped away from the table for a minute. There's a nice close-up view of the rack. You can see the lights above, the reflection of the lights above, and the balls there. This is not a pretty table here. Got some problems on this table. Not a problem with the 5 and the 6. 4 ball's not easy. Yeah. Tony got a pretty good roll there. Anthony is really tough one. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, this is going to be a close hit. Bad hit. Tony with ball in hand here. Anthony is not going to like this next shot.
You don't think?
No, this is going to be brutal right here. So Tony's going to thin the one, snuggle that up behind the 6 and the 4, and send the cue ball down table to the bottom rail. And back up. Wow. Actually, that could have been worse. Yeah, I think Anthony's got an opportunity to hit that now. That could have been a lot worse. If he got the cue ball behind any of those balls down there. Good hit.
That's a good hit. But again, it's going to come right back and bite him again.
Right. But he's still alive.
He's not alive and no fouls. He can hit this pretty easy. Well, no, I take that back. He's frozen to that four, isn't he?
I don't think he's frozen. There might be a slight gap there, but.
Okay. Let's see in a second. Yep, he got away with it.
Mm-hmm. And now, Tony doesn't really have a shot.
Oh, I think he does.
Well, the 8-ball looks like it's blocking.
I don't think so.
No?
I don't know that he can make. Oh, no, he's going behind it. He's going to try and come down there. Yeah. Oh, don't do that. I think Tony likes that.
No.
Wow. That's dead end.
Dead end, huh?
It's dead end. How would you
on
ever
this
miss
table?
That shot?
Yeah, I don't know. You wouldn't. I can see myself missing this. One ball's off the rail just slightly, and the 9-ball's frozen on the rail, looks like.
Yes.
So he's got a couple options here. It looks like try to play a carom into the 9, or he could try to cut the 1-ball into the 9.
I don't like the carom. I don't know if he has enough room there. But we'll find out.
Nice shot.
Enough room?
Yep. Good shot.
Wow. He's tightening this up.
Mm-hmm. 6-5 now. Wow.
Yep.
Things are closing in.
Just a couple of rolls change everything.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. The momentum has swung.
Yep, 6-5.
They are playing for $3,000, folks.
Yes, they are. Race to 11.
Mm-hmm.
Though right now it's anybody's match.
Right. Anthony breaking game number 12.
Powerful break. Breaks like hard, like Shane Van Boney breaks. 10-ball racks.
Out. Anthony's option, take the shot or turn it back over to Tony.
Well, he tried to thin that one earlier, so I imagine he'll try and thin it again. Got the 7 as a blocker there, you know, if he hits it real good.
Better shot right there. That's a good shot.
That's a good shot. Hey, put Tony in a little bit of front here.
He's going to curve it around the 8-ball and the bottom rail. Well, bad hit.
Yeah. That was tough. That was tough to get to. He gets stroking good, man. He just makes some shots.
Playing this one left-handed.
on a roll now. He's got his confidence back after them few.
It's a more manageable situation for him right here. You know,
oh, yeah.
One game deficit opposed to what it was earlier, like four games.
Exactly. You're on your way to tying it up right here. Putting the pressure back on Tony. But I think Tony plays better under the pressure.
Mm-hmm. Well, we've seen that several matches in a row there.
Seems to focus more.
Yeah. See what happens here. We still got a long way to go.
Oh, yeah.
Chipper, this is the finals. We got race to 11 here. Right now it stands 6-5, Tony Crosby over Anthony Meglino.
3,000 to first.
3,000 for first, 1,000 for second place. I think that's the same Chipper that I know.
Yeah, probably. We don't ever see him anymore. But
no.
We know he's out there and doing well. It is the finals. Race to 11.
Okay, nice shooting there by Anthony. 6-6 ties it up.
6. Race to 5.
Nice close matches. Seeing quite
like
a few. We saw some good matches today. I mean, several of them went hill-hill.
Yeah.
A couple of them were heartbreaking on one side. I mean,
you
know.
Yeah.
But
good for the spectators.
Yeah, good matches. Players played well.
Yes, they did. All played good. Definitely some of the best players in Florida. Tied up.
Okay, game
Anthony
number
with
13.
Sledgehammer break here. Three ball made no.
Nothing on the break.
Nothing on the break. Not a great shot, but kind of got a clean shot at the one. Put it down here by the nine ball, but then he'll be scared of that. Let's see what he does.
Oh, if he gets it behind the four, that's going to be fantastic right there. Good shot.
Yes. 1-9 will be played if Anthony doesn't get a hit.
Thanks. Well, I don't know, but he might play that, but we'll see what happens.
I'm thinking to myself. Where's the nine? That's the first thing I always say.
Is it?
Good
nice
hit.
Hit.
Good hit. And he got a.
Wow.
He didn't get a lockup lead. But,
he left it tough for,
yeah, but
for Tony.
I think well, you think that six has him?
No. I think
he's
got a
clean
shot.
Shot,
yeah. Still a tough shot. I mean,
oh, yeah,
he got like 15 foot shot.
Safe out of this.
Just kept
that
rolling.
One slowed up. Nope. Yeah. Anthony got a trouble-free table.
Yeah, getting on that two ball.
That's it. If he gets on the two, could be. Yeah. Well, let's see what he does.
If he makes all the balls, he should get out.
Yeah, if he does, he'll probably. He's going to take the corner shot with it. That's a smart shot, really.
Mm-hmm.
Then he gets in line. So, yeah, I wouldn't take that because I couldn't make it.
Gotta have some confidence in the game. I've seen
really.
You drill these.
probably when I was trying to bank it. Skimmed it.
Six ball. He's still all right. Oh, yeah. Just a little more difficult than he wanted here. Yeah. He's got the cue ball next to the rail. But if he can just make the three ball and stop right there, it's perfect for the four.
Looks like that's what he's going to try and do.
Not so easy. Those are tough shots. Those side pockets are tough.
They're tough.
And anybody just tuning in, unfamiliar with this table, it's 4.5-inch side pockets there. It's pretty tough. Got a
favorable.
Nice kiss off the three and got a safe out of that.
Yes, he did. Tony needs to get a little rhythm going. You know, he hasn't been at the table
he let
much.
Some games slip away from him here, missing a couple little shots here and there.
Yep. Hasn't gotten his rhythm. Well, Anthony just fouled. Wow.
Miss that one.
Well, see what Tony can do here if he can get in gear.
Actually,
right.
Came down.
Yeah,
yeah, it's
all
not
right.
As bad as it could have been.
I thought he was only going to roll right on it. I thought he'd draw back on that, but that was a good shot.
Mm-hmm. Let's go forward now.
Yeah.
And change hands here.
It's going to be steep here.
A little tester shot here.
Oh, yeah, this one's tough. He just overhit that a little bit.
This would be better for a left-handed.
Oh, wow, that's tough for him.
Yeah. All right, 7-6. Race to 11. You're watching Xtreme Pool Challenge. We're streaming live from Cocoa Beach, Florida. I'm Rick Heffelfink alongside Gary Patrick. This is our Fate of the Eight, number 7 finals. A $3,000 the six ball. He's got a shot at the one ball. Hit.
You're lucky.
Well, that's going to leave Tony a shot at the two ball, though. Okay, the shot here to go to 8. Okay, nice effort by Tony. 8-6 in a race to 11. You're watching the Xtreme Pool Challenge. Streaming live from Cocoa Beach, Florida. I want to thank our sponsors again, Simona's Cloth and Clean Cloth out there. They've been in business since 1680. And both of our tables are covered with Simona's 860 Tournament Blue HR Series cloth. And also want to thank Mark Gregory for restoring our tables from Perfect Pockets of Atlanta, Georgia. Look him up on the web, perfectpocketswithaz.com, or give him a call at 770-548-4292 if you're in the market for any table repairs or any work done. Seven ball. He's got a shot at the one. came out really nice for Tony. That's, that helped him out a lot there, bumping that four ball up the table. Let's see what kind of angle he has now. He's almost straight in on this four ball, so he left himself too straight, I think. He might have a little bit of angle here. Yeah, he did.
Six.
Well, he left himself almost straight in on the four ball right before the five, so he rolled down there. He got pretty good on the five, left the cue ball on the rail, so limited his
Well, big opportunity
choices
for Anthony right now that he wasn't, I don't think, expecting. Mm-hmm. So he can get seven here.
Yeah, he gets out here. It's,
and then he's breaking. His break is brutal.
Mm-hmm. Said earlier, he put together three racks his first match, breaking round.
Yes, okay, very capable.
Mm-hmm. He's one, ran one or two here, I think.
Taking his extension.
Mm-hmm. It's good to just settle down and make the ball.
Yep. Yeah, this is a big swing for
this is a big
both
game,
of them,
right?
Really.
Yeah.
Been a huge lead for Tony. And
every game from here on out is very important.
Yes, they are.
Players.
Oh,
that's,
wow. Boy. Wow. That hurts. That does. Sometimes when you think about the shot too long, you overcorrect it or something. But he was right there. It was right there. Tony just overrolled this one bad.
I think he can make it. He's just composing himself here. He's thinking about it. But you got to bear down on these shots. You can't really take them for granted. You ask for an extension. See, he's looking at the shot again. Nice shot there. Okay, so Tony goes to 9-6. Race to 11. Interested in more information about our events coming up, check out our events calendar on the web page. Also, if you're interested in playing in one of these events, there's some contact information on the front page. Get a hold of Gary and he'll set that up for you. Okay, Tony breaking game number 16 now. Break. Anthony can see the one ball. See what he can do here. Try to play safe, I imagine. Nice shot there. That was a great save. Came down. Important one for Tony to hit. Great shot.
Good player, friend of mine from before Shane. Morrow, he was trying to say hi to Joe Tucker. Joe's gone, isn't he? Or is he out there? Oh, he's out there. Okay.
That made a good hit. Let's see here. Does. Got a little problem with the five ball sitting right there against the rail near the side pocket.
Yeah, but with those other two balls, depending on where he ends up, he can kick it out. Got to make this two ball first.
Mm-hmm. He doesn't like that. Options here.
Yes, yeah. He is. Might be time to play safe. Where? Let's see what he does. Unless he draws all the way over and back or something, I don't know. Looks bad. He's gonna do something.
That's for
he
sure.
He has something in mind.
He must.
His knowledge level is above mine, so.
I don't know. Let's see what he does here.
Yeah, this is a tough spot.
Extension.
Taking his extension. Can't really play a real great safe to where, I don't know. Let's see what he does. Left him a straight on shot.
Yeah, it's not much to work with right there. At least you can make a good hit there.
But well, he could make the ball, but then what's he get if he makes it?
Right, yeah, he's still got problems with that five ball.
He's looking at that nine ball, taking a swing.
I think
he's going to try and park the cue ball behind the six somehow.
That would be a better choice right here. I think if he can thin the four into the nine.
Too bad we don't have a telestrator, I'm telling
here.
You.
Here.
he just tried to get it down to the... Now that was a good attempt there, Rick.
I don't know what to do sometimes. Some of these guys...
No, I don't know. I don't know what I would do.
They think differently.
Oops.
Well... That was lucky there because you had a double hit. Now you created, you know, Tony really doesn't have a shot there,
well,
too.
He,
but
he
he's
parked you behind that six now.
He's going to try to get behind the six and send
that's what I think.
Send the four ball down this way. Look at that.
Harder.
Almost. Nah, didn't roll enough.
Didn't get it. But, you know, even if you make this four ball, what do you do next?
Yeah, you don't have a good shot at the five, that's for sure.
No.
You got to wait for somebody to make
that mistake.
Make a stake.
Yeah. I think I'd have to miss this one again. Of course, that's easy for me to do. He's actually left him a breakout if he wants to take the chance.
Yeah, I don't know if now's the time to try that. That's pretty risky right there because if you hit the bottom, you know.
I think he has to play safe. I mean, with Crosby on nine, you know, I think Tony has to,
yeah, you gotta,
he has to wait.
Yeah, wait for your time.
Yeah.
A better chance.
But he might go for this. He did.
Yeah, he did. Well, broke the five out and he got a roll
out
of it.
He got away with it. But that was just a lucky roll there.
Mm-hmm.
Tony will hit this ball, but you know, there again, if it doesn't stop somewhere tough, Anthony gets an opportunity. It's going to leave him a wide open shot. Extension. And again, out there, don't forget to tune in next Saturday and Sunday to watch us up at Tingali's in Tallahassee. $8,000 guaranteed purse, $65 entry, a race to nine. On the winner's side, seven on the loser's side. And I believe they're doing a race to 11 in the final. We'll be streaming it live. Be streaming three or four tables. So should be a good night. If you live close enough or in distance, it'll probably be worth going to play in it.
Come up
short.
Yeah.
Well, he was extended out there. Anthony, a very good one pocket player, a good banker. Does he play safe or does he go for it? I think he's got to play safe with Tony at nine. Race
well,
to
if
11.
He banks this one short.
Yeah, I don't know. Let's see what he does. Yeah, that was a good play. He's trying to get behind the eight. But that's still a good play regardless.
Right.
Come off the right side of this one, don't you think?
Well, that's a tough one because you would come off the right side and you go around two rails, well, three rails, and maybe try to get behind the eight ball, but he went the other way.
Yeah, just he's just going to
play the easier position. Well, left Anthony a makeable shot here on the seven.
Oh, yeah.
He just has to go back and forth across the table here. He's just cue this one high and let the ball go back and forth across the table.
Come upstream a little ways if he wants. You just got to
watch
put them side pockets.
A little bit of right on here. But
very nice shot.
Yeah.
Did what you said.
Mm-hmm. Don't want to make that one any tougher than it has to be.
Just true.
Just make the ball. And this came out really nice for him right here.
Oh, yeah.
He got the eight ball.
Yeah.
He's a little bit off the rail there. He's got a little angle on the eight. It's a stop shot. Forward a little bit. And now you're just to go to seven.
Right,
9-7. Tony Crosby, two games ahead of Anthony Meglino in the race to 11.
Yeah. Well, that was a good win for Anthony. Tony won away from the hill. That break of Anthony's is always scary. He usually makes balls and controls the cue ball pretty well. they go. There go.
No.
Oh. Ooh, almost scratched on the side.
Yeah.
What was that?
Yeah, nothing on the break. Oh, wait.
No,
I yeah, he made a ball on the break.
Yeah,
I'm sorry. Mistake.
He might be able to make
the
that
six
one.
Ball. I don't know how far that out.
I think he can make that in there. Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Well, if he can, he's going for it.
Oh yeah, yeah, he's got to go for it. It's a big game here. Oh no! But now Tony can make it. I don't know if he overcut that or what he was trying to do.
I don't know. Maybe he was just trying to come down table. I don't know.
My angle, it looked like he could cut it in there, but maybe. Hits that. Oh, well, he did good.
That could have been worse.
Oh, I mean, yeah, a lot worse.
Nice shot for the corner. This one here could be a little tricky, but try to play this one the side, or he could try to draw to the side rail and come up above the four ball.
Yeah, I don't think you want to play that in the side.
Yeah, good shot there.
Not even tight inside.
Nope.
At that angle.
This one just get closer to the middle of the table here after.
Plus the side pocket shelves don't stay way out like on a lot of tables, you know.
Mm-hmm.
They're deep for a side pocket. Five to the seven. What's he going to do here, Rick?
You got to go three rails. I mean, he's got to hit.
What about that eight ball?
Yeah, that's the thing. You got to put enough spin on it so you come up above the eight ball. That's the eight ball. So he's putting
his
right-hand angle shot. Oh, no, he just drew it back and forth. Okay, yeah. Nice shot.
I think he got over there far enough.
Yeah, I think that's fine. Mm-hmm. That's perfect.
Mm-hmm. Mm. A little further, it would have been easier, but I think he's okay.
Nice shot there.
Oh, very nice.
Good speed control.
Very nice.
Right on the nine ball. And the shot here to go to 10, put himself on the hill.
Yes.
Okay, good shooting there by Tony. 10-7.
10-7. Anthony got
11.
Got an uphill battle now.
Yes, he does.
Got to win four in a row.
Yeah, which he's very capable of doing. I mean,
I saw him break and run three backs.
Mm-hmm.
Early. That's pretty strong on the 10-footer.
Yes, it is. This needs to maintain control of the table here. If we get opportunity, got to play smart here. Thank you.
guys in here, he said the stream is great. That's good to hear.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Tony missed that one. Now Anthony has another opportunity here.
Oh, no.
Well, it didn't come up high enough there on that three ball.
Playing a little conservative. Is he going to go to the back? No, he can't. Not with Tony on the hill.
Yeah, you got to
gotta play safe.
Make a smart decision here.
Yeah.
So.
I mean, he could go for
the nine.
He could
back cut it. Well, but, he could back cut the three, but I don't know. You know, not won the game. $3,000 versus $1,000, you know.
Hey, you want to make the right decision.
Yeah.
Here.
Yeah. He's going to back cut that sucker. Take his chances, I guess.
Nice shot.
It was a nice shot. If he'd have missed that five, he'd have been. Well, and then the 7-9 tie up a little bit.
Well, you're worried about that problem in a minute. You got a
shot right here. You're still at the table.
Yeah, it's unfortunate.
He can hide behind the six ball. You know, he may try to get behind that six. See what he does. Oh, he overhit that. Overhit it and left Tony a shot. I think.
Yeah, it looks like Tony's got a shot at the full ball there.
Yeah, it does.
Which is not good. Not good for Anthony.
Depending on where this cue ball stops. Stopped in a favorable spot for Tony. What's he going to do with the 7 ball?
I don't know. I don't think it goes in either corner pocket.
Well, it'll go in the down where the 6 is going to go.
Right. It'll go in the upper corner pocket. Yeah. And so he's got to draw back to the side rail and back down to the bottom rail. Get underneath the 7, which is doable from right here in this position. Hit a little too firm.
Yeah.
Now he's
got a problem.
Got a tough shot here.
He could carom it right into the corner.
Carom it?
Off the 9.
He could.
Playing the safe. That was
a good move right there.
He hit it a little hard, but he had to get it to the rail.
Putting some pressure on Anthony here, you get him back to the table. And he's got to come with a shot here or play a good safe.
Tough spot to be in.
Mm-hmm.
Your opponent's on the hill. $1,000.
He missed the whole ball.
Oh, wow.
That is not what he wanted to do. Wow. That's unfortunate for Anthony. Yeah. I mean, just missing. Yeah. You want to go down swinging.
Yeah.
But you want.
Sometimes, you know, in them thin ones, you just over thin them.
Yeah, that's unfortunate for Anthony.
Yeah.
That's a tough break. Okay, this for the win right here, right. Tony. $3,000 right here.
Yes, it is. Well, he got a new young one on the way, I'm sure.
Okay, congratulations to 25 being 11-7 over Anthony Meglino. This is Xtreme Pools Challenge. This was our fate of that 8, number 7 that you were watching. That was a completion of it. So we got $1,000 to Anthony Meglino and $3,000 to the winner, Tony Crosby. I want to thank our sponsors once again, Simona's Cloth and Perfect Pockets. Also, I'd like to thank all the people that tuned in and watched.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Participation in the chat room. Thank you very much. Remember, next week we will be in Tallahassee at Zingali's for their tournament. Tune in next week for that. We'll see you soon. Check out the event calendar. So long, everybody. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.